Good morning, everyone. It is Saturday morning. I keep thinking it's Sunday, but it is Saturday. And I'm going to, let's not do that right now. I'm going to tell you about this idea I came up with. And I've been over YouTube and Instagram looking for something similar, but it's not there, so it's new. So surprise, surprise. Okay, first I've been, as you can see, I've started putting lacquer on, varnish, to make them really nice and shiny. And of course I've been sanding a lot of this, but as you can see how really pretty this is turning out to be. Let me see if I can get you in really close. Not that sharp. I think I might have to look into some new sort of camera by the time I move and I get in my attic. Some new setup, you know, to make a little bit better videos. But this one is really beautiful. Look how smooth that is. And it's a really nice size to put on a necklace. And a little one there, a long one there. Nice and smooth and has a little varnish on it, but they need a lot of varnish. So this one I'm going to be putting beads in the middle, in the little dent that's in it. And they are really, really nice. Nice and smooth. So I'm excited to work on that. Then I found a shell, which I really, just on normal mussel, you know. We call them mussels. I don't know how you call them. Cockles, mussels, I don't know. As you can see, I lacquered it, but I did a little sandpaper, a 400 grit. That's really smooth to take a little bit of that crusty stuff off, and then I used lacquer. And it is popping up. This is really nice and blue. Looks like Delft blue. I really like that. That's the other side where I didn't put the lacquer on, and I didn't sand it, so you can see the difference. That is beautiful. Just a normal shell. You can find 6 million of these. 6 million. You can find a lot of them on the beach, and normally no one does anything with them. And I'm thinking maybe I'll do a lot of these and then do some kind of a mosaic. I don't know, something like that. But when I see stuff, I get all these ideas, and sometimes I wish I didn't. Okay, what have I been doing and what is new? So last week I showed you, you know, how to do the clay and the beads and the stuff. Let me get you in a little bit closer if I can. Let's see. No, it's only giving you more. That is, nope, we don't want that. That's okay. But we want, yeah, here we go. Okay, so the clay, I made those beads, you know, these ones that I was gonna put in a painting. Well, I'm still going to, but that's gonna have to wait a little bit because I've come up with something else. I always come up with something else. So while I was playing with the clay, I thought, hey, why don't we make other stuff out of that clay? So I tried a few feathers, didn't like them, don't like them that much. These I love, these I'm going to be putting in a painting. These are really cute, these tiny little fossiled something or other, so I don't know what you call them. Then I did the a little bit better feather. I like that one, so I'm gonna work with that one. Then I thought, you know what, I'm gonna make my own silicone molds. So I started, you know, this has to be something that looks like a flower bud at the bottom here, and I thought I'd make a silicone mold, then put the clay in, then I can, you know, shape it like what I want and then let it dry, and then I could use it in my painting. So I was started on that, as you can see here, with the little leaves on it. And here's a really bigger one, which I really don't like anymore, but okay. So I started off with that. And then all of a sudden I thought, hey, wait a minute, we're gonna make something really interesting. Let me put that there for the light here. So I started making all these little flowers. Oops, not that one. That is still some of those fossils. But I started making these little flowers. And I really enjoyed making them. Look at that. Are they not cute? All sorts. And really, really tiny ones too. See that little tiny flower? Now, of course, that is takes a lot of time to make these one by one. So then I thought, how can I, you know, speed this process up a little bit? And I thought, I'm going to make a video about it with you guys, because you might, you know, want to get into this too. So what I did is I made little stamps. Now, this is the little flower. Of course, it has to be flatter than this because this is too thick to work with. So let's roll that out a little bit. And that's about okay. But while I'm doing this, think about the possibilities. Because, you know, if you make your own little stamp, and I'm going to put that in there. See how nicely it presses these little petals into it? Then I add another one with a raised middle. So we have that one. Then I made one with a raised middle but bigger. And another one with different petals. Then I made one where it goes down. See that? And they are just, you know, free because I made them myself with the clay I had left over. Here's another one. This one is really nice with the raised center. I love that one. And then, of course, the bigger one. Now, when you have that, when you've got it, all you have to do is find something like big enough. This is from some sort of a little spray thing. Big enough to go over it. And you just cut it out. I'll just do one. See that? And then when you leave it on the table like that, you get some little tool, anything will work, and you just press the petals into it a little, like that. Make a little smooth. And you can do that as much as you like. You can even put the petals on top, like I'm doing now. You get the idea. You guys are smart. So when it's ready, you get a little palette knife, and there you go, you have a little flower. See that? Now you let them dry, and then you can do anything with them what you want. You could put them on a little wooden box or whatever, but I'm going to be using them in a painting. And the thing is that I'm still waiting for some stencils, because I'm really in need of a really big mandala stencil. And I thought about making my own, but that is really a lot of work, because see how pretty these are. I just love doing that. You know, I put on a podcast, and even, you know, I have these really sharp tools to do the little ones. That's a little bit too little. Let's go a little bit bigger. And there you go. See how, oops, perfectly it just, you know, punches out that little round thingy. Then I do that with my fingers. And of course, yeah, it's a little bit too small, but what I do is I make it a little bit flowery, just pressing in one of those cheap AliExpress tools, and then we have another little flower. Now, I can do this for hours, and it is really zen. So anyone that has a really busy day and wants to, you know, unwind a little, clay is so satisfying. It really is. I love playing with it. I don't know why that is. I think some memories from kindergarten. I don't know, but it's a lot of fun to do stuff with clay. So just pressing it in, making it a little flowery. And we have another flower. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put this away. What I'm gonna do is put the mandala in the middle as the center point. And then I'm gonna come in with these beautiful little flowers and leaves. And I'm gonna smirk it up a little bit. Now I did try to make a stamp for the leaves because that is a lot of work too, but that didn't work out as well as I hoped. There's a bit of my hair in there, red hair, because I made a little leaf stamp, and when you stamp into it, oops, there's not enough definition for a really nice little leaf. So then there's another way that I do the leaves. Show you that too, just in case you're gonna try and do this also. Oh, and like I said, I was all over YouTube and Instagram, and I have not seen anyone do this, so I think that's kind of cool that we have a little bit, you know, something that no one has done. So when you have this, a little roundy thing for the leaves, I press it down a little. This one is a little too thick, but that's okay. Where's my other stick? I lost my other stick? Oh no, there it is. Oops. Okay, so then I just press these two things together. See that? And it's already instant leaf. I want it a little bit bigger, so then I press it down. Make it really pointy at first. And then just press it, and you see that it's getting this leaf sort of a thing going on. And then I get this really sharp, another tool from AliExpress, and I go straight through the middle. I'll bring it up in a bit. Well, I can do that maybe here. So there is your leaf, and then all you have to do is press these little side things in it. I know it's a lot of work, but guys, this is so satisfying. Like I said, podcast or something on TV, and a cup of coffee, and then it's Zen time. So pull this one in a little bit like that, and there you have your little leaf. Now they, if you're going to be putting them on the painting, I don't think they should be too thick, because then they'll be, you know, very high, raised up too high. So either you can go over it again, make it a little bigger, like that. Or you can just roll out the clay a little thinner, like I usually do. I'm trying to keep everything in the sort of the same thickness. So what I use is, like I said before, these stir sticks for paint. I put my clay in the middle, like that. And then I roll over it just as long as it's flat, and then you get this thickness. And these come in different widths, so you can see what works for you best. Okay, that was 15 minutes of how I was playing with clay all week. And there's a lot of them. I really like these little tiny ones. They are really cute. So I'm going to see. I tried a few other sizes of leaves, different ways to make them, but they're not that pretty. And of course, when you have one of these, what you can do, and that's how I make my stamps, I just get a piece of clay and put the nice side in the clay, and then it's like, you know, making your own silicone molds almost. Then I just cut away most of the clay. This is just satisfying. I love this. And then you take it off and see, that was the that's the good one. This is the reverse, because you want to have the reverse, because when this is dry, you press it in, you get this. Just make it a little bit more like shape of a leaf. And if you want to, you can even, let's see where I got my other little tool. I got all these cheap tools. They're all from Ollie. These are like so cheap. If you want them a little deeper, you can press that in there before it dries. And that'll give you a little bit more of a raised leaf look. So that's okay to do that. I'm sure you're hearing that I'm almost zen right now. This is okay. So we'll just keep that one for tomorrow. So that's what I was doing all week. And of course, ordering a lot of stuff that I want, all sorts of stencils. But the deal is, here in Holland, if I buy a stencil here, I will be paying, like, for one stencil about 20 euros. And if I buy them in, you know, the AliExpress, I'll have like 20 stencils for the same amount of money. So I'll just have to wait. And I know they're coming, because I just got a little reminder that they will be ready for pickup the 19th of June. They're going to be here. That's in a couple, 2 weeks. That's okay. I'm going to be making a test piece. So after this video, I'm going to work. I'll show you. So this is the canvas. Let me get you a little wider. This is the canvas. And I'm going to be putting this stencil on here. And I'm going to use this stencil for the border, which is going to go all around. And then from here, the flowers and the leaves and, I don't know, something like that. Like here. And then, you know, it won't be like it's all the same, because, you know, this is, every single little leaf I made is different. So the only thing that's going to be the same is this. But these, I hope I have enough. Put a little one there. And a little flower up here. And then a few tiny flowers. Are you getting the idea, guys? And of course, I'm going to be doing this with the Italian pigments, because I really want that Italian sort of a look going on. The Mediterranean, that's what I'm going for. So that's going to be put there. Oh, I'm already really excited in making this. But that might be a really long video if I do it all online, because this is my first time I'm doing this. Usually when I've made one or two, then, you know, I get a little faster. There you go. Oops, what's that? Oh, that's a little flower. Yeah? You guys think that's cool? I do. So I'm gonna make it. Even though you might not like it, but I like this. And then if this works, then when I get my other stencils, which are bigger, I'm going to do a meter by a meter. So that's about, like, say, 3.5 foot by 3.5 foot. And I'm going to keep that one for my living room in my new house. That's what I decided. Okie dokie. Thanks for watching, guys. Love you all to pieces, as always. And I'll be right back when I make this thing together. Right? Thanks for watching. Laters.